us to read from the book of Hebrews, chapter 12. The book of Hebrews. You don't just give me a soft string. Something soft. Thank you, Jesus. The book of Hebrews, chapter 12. The Bible reads, therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight, the sin which easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is before us. How many of us are running the race of salvation with endurance? How many of us are resisting temptation that easily ensnares us? How many of us are saying, I will not be tempted, I'll resist what is coming upon my life? The Bible here is telling us, let us run with endurance the race. It says, put aside every weight that easily ensnares you. What easily ensnares you? What easily ensnares you? What easily causes you to reach April in the entire year? Wanaka. You begin to backslide as a Christian only in April. When you began the year, you made declarations. You cut a covenant with your God. You made promises that this year you will be a better person. You made resolutions. That's why I hate resolutions. I would rather decide today and do it today, and not plan it for next year or plan it for a day to come. Whatever you desire to do for God, do it now. Whatever you want to do for your master, begin it today. Begin it right now. It will never happen if you say, this year I'm going to. Just say, this year I am. This year I am this. This year I am a better person. Whether you like me, you don't like me, I am not the same person you met last year. I'm not the same person you looked at last year. Whether you think I walk in the same every Sunday, every time there is service, that's your problem. In the realm of the spirit, my Lord is making a change. Somewhere in the spirit, there is a registration that there is a change inside of me. There is a witness within that which easily ensnares. Some of us, we fail to leave sin. Some of us pretend. Today's Christian, today's body of Christ is full of liars, mockers. It's full of people that come into the church just to receive. You've made the church your bank account. You come just to withdraw your blessings and you go. Who will build this sanctuary? Who will build the church of God? Who is going to witness to the next person if the Christian has laid his heart only to receive? Father, bless me is all we know. Father, bless me. Father, bless me. I have a stagnant life. Let there be a movement in my life. When there is movement, we don't see you in church. The true church is lying in a grave today, because there are many that have come in the name of Jesus. The Antichrist spirit is in every church. Sometimes I get very worried when I see somebody open a church and in 2 days it's filled to capacity. I begin to wonder, what God are they worshiping? Because the true church, it still travails in prayer. It is still struggling in the prayer zone. Amen. People are running to church for prosperity and not to resist sin. There are altars that are built all over the world where the message of repentance is never heard. It's only the message of prosperity. Only the message of let us break. How can you break curses when you have not repented? How can you break generational bondage when you have not repented? How can you come and declare, I need deliverance, when you have not repented? You have not heard the gospel of John. Repent, bear fruits that are worthy of the kingdom. To avere sasana, break, break by fire, break by fire. Now lelanda, break by fire. You have not resisted the enemy to the point of death. You are a liar. Nothing breaks because you are not broken. Nothing breaks in you because you are not broken. And until you break, the Lord breaks that which is upon your life. The message is simple. You have not resisted that which easily ensnares you. Your boss is calling you with a running nose. You are drooling over your desk. And when it comes to church, I've got flu. Come on. It's a fact of life that we are witnessing. Our work, our jobs have become our gods. When you want to go to the office, even with a broken leg, you appear before your boss, your taskmaster. But when it comes for you to come to church, you call in and you say, Pastor, I'm not coming, I've got a broken leg. Come and pray for me at home. Iwe. Nakulombere chisuma. Mwana wako alesa uchirule angala. You play with salvation. Put at the price of death. Sometimes I'm tempted to pick up an entire congregation and say, let's go to the grave. Pick your own. Because that is what it cost Jesus. On a Saturday like this, he was in battle in the grave, defeating death. The one that you are now embracing. Sin is death. Tell your neighbor, sin is eternal death. It's internal condemnation. The very battle that Jesus came to fight, the very battle that Jesus was against, the very battle that caused him to accept to be put in a grave so that you will never have to lie in an eternal grave. The Bible says we have not resisted. We have not resisted. Amen. Verse 2, it says, look unto Jesus, the author, the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of his God. For consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself, lest you become weary and you are discouraged in your souls. You have not yet resisted unto bloodshed, striving against sin. You have not yet resisted unto bloodshed, striving against sin. We are dressed like this today because we are in a warfare against this creature called sin. Kukana jinja. Amen. If there's one thing that a human being resists, is change. Those people that are filling up in the wrong places, I don't want to mention places. You know where people are. Are drawing more patrons than the church. Brothels are more packed than the house of God. It should cause you to shed tears. If you have travailed in prayer, it should make you begin to say, God, where are they going? That are filling up these places. Occultism all over the world is drawing masses. The church is getting more empty. I sometimes begin to shudder in my spirit. How many will be saved? I look around and I say, I used to see a brother in that chair. Will he make it to heaven? I did my part. I introduced Jesus, but they grew weary in their soul. I look at another chair and I say, somebody used to sit there. Where are they today? Will they make heaven when the trumpet sounds? Have you sat down and asked yourself, will I make heaven if the trumpet was to sound today? Chalo twatemwesha ukwenda efyo twatemwa twatemwesha ukuchindika. What we want, our will be done. We live upside down, we walk upside down, we even pray upside down. We pray amiss because we don't know what we ought to be praying for. Father, give me a car. You will never go with your car to heaven. Father, give me a husband. You will never go to heaven with your husband. Chiramuntu, I've told you, this is a weekend of personal. It's personal. Tell your neighbor, it's personal. It's not about your husband. It's not about your wife. It's not about that girlfriend. It's not about that boyfriend. It's not about the job you're crying about. Ukafishiaiwe. It's not about the house you are crying for. It's not about the riches you want to gain. It's about salvation. Naked I come into this world, naked I'll leave. But I'll not be empty. Tell your neighbor, for me I'll not be empty. For on the inside of me I'll be fully laden with my God. I'll be fully consumed in my God. I'll be fully blessed in my God. I'll carry the full load of what it takes to enter eternal life. For my treasures are not of this world. I don't battle for the treasures of the world. I've given up everything for the sake of the kingdom. I've surrendered everything for the sake of the kingdom. For the sake of eternal glory. Money doesn't matter over my life eternally. Even marriage will not matter over my life eternally. I tell you, even a beautiful house, it did not matter to John the Baptist. The Bible says he lived in the mountains eating curds and honey, locusts. Wow! John didn't want a house. The Bible says there's never been greater amongst the prophets than John. Because maybe the prophets had wealth that was physical that they could see. But John spent his time giving his this life so we can repent. We can hear the message. Repent. Bear fruits worthy. How many times has this message been preached? I want us to pray and say, God, give me a view of heaven. Do you see my image there? Do you see me there? Fue wengi tatukumanisha. Because we have not resisted to the point of death, to the point of bleeding. We have not resisted. Some of you, you know where you are right now. It's the wrong place. You have not resisted our place. Some of you, you know where you have decided to associate. It's the wrong place. You have not resisted to the point of death. You are comfortable because there is something that you are getting out of it. There is some satisfaction. Iwe kuzikongweresa kuzakuleterera to cost you. God never made hell for a human being, even the worst murderer. I don't know what that criminal on the side of Jesus did. He accepted, he said, I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus, remember me when you enter into your glory today. I believe God opened the eyes of both of them, because I know that at the point of death, they stop looking into the eyes of people. Suddenly they are very extremely quiet, and they are, the first thing that closes is their mouth. They can't say what they are doing, but they are beholding the glory. They are beholding something is coming. I always wonder, what do you think it feels like to succumb to death? I remember when I faced my own death years ago. That kept on closed upon my life. Could see a way open, and I said, God, is this the end? At the hand of a criminal has pulled the trigger. Is this how I'm going to go? Is this how I'm dying, Lord? The curtain closed. I was not ready, but I was a Christian. I was not ready, yet I said, Lord Jesus, come into my heart, be the Lord of my life. Me, death does not knock. Death does not warn you. Death does not say ni pwera mahiro ukonzeke. Death does not say ni pwera mumazulo dikumane. Death does not say I'm dala mulina one day. Death can enter any minute. It closed on me at a time when I was in sin. I knew I was a Christian. Death entered. The curtain closed. I remember crying in that dark place. Lord, give me one more chance. Just one. Just one. I didn't do something right. I didn't do something right. I didn't do something right. That was my prayer. Lord, just one time. And I remember in that place, God coming through. He said, if I send you back, what do you want to do that you didn't do? My friend, you may not have the chance I was given. He said, I gave you enough time. What is it you will not do? What is it you didn't do that you want to go back to? He said, Lord, just one. I know. You get me from here. I'm going somewhere I didn't plan to go. We all plan to be in heaven, but we don't live like heaven has. We all plan, and when we are asked, are you saved? Are you going to heaven? And millions will say yes, but we don't live like people going to heaven. We live like people in hell. We live like people that I destroyed already. yet we call ourselves Christian. Not resisting the point of death. I've smelled death, I've seen death, I've come to smell it, and I've been put amongst the dead. Counted as one of the corpses. I sat there and said, God, one more, just one more chance. I'm a Christian, but I didn't live like one. When God said, go back, made up my mind, Lord Jesus. Even when I'm sick, I get up and I preach. Even when it's paining, I get up and I preach. Up to now, I still have a knee injury. I still get up and preach. It's not bigger than my salvation. It's not greater than what God has put on the inside. Nangundwale, I will still preach the gospel of repentance. Because I know death will never knock to you. What is the spiritual warfare about today? Resistance of sin. Resist the enemy. He will flee from you. Resist him. He will let you go. Resist him to the point where you want to die. Many of us solve only 90%, only 60% of our troubles in prayer. We forget 30% ni kaguru. Ogangena business deal wakupasa 30% ni kuru. We solve only 60% and we are comfortable. But if we are to take the other 30 in prayer, we have a full 100% in the presence of God. This should not just be a ceremony. Every year, Holy Saturday, Holy Saturday, Happy Easter. Mambo pasana na machocolate. What has chocolate got to do with salvation? Chocolate yamine yamine pasana mwewe nango. Iku peregani na mchimo inango. Because we don't know what this day means. We have no idea what God is saying in our hearts. We have not yet entered Gethsemane and begun to travail, begun to agonize. The Bible says when his disciples heard him agonize, they heard him pray. They didn't understand what was happening to him. Says that's the time he sweated blood. Have you sweated blood before concerning your life? Concerning your children, your family? Concerning that brother, that sister you desire to be saved? My God, it's a challenge. Amen. Many of you will look solemn and so sad and so downcast. Ngati ndimwe vandu vabwino, ngati vingena. But vingena vichokera kwa other side. Preach this message over. You preach this message over. You speak this message a million times. But still, your hearts are carnal. You need to resist carnality. Least resist the flesh. It's your biggest enemy. Hello, somebody. I want you to rise up to our feet. Begin to pray. This battlefront is against sin. That which easily causes you to backslide. I don't understand how a Christian backslide. Because that day when God gave me a second chance to come back to life, I told him, I'm not going back. Lord, I'm not going back that way. I'm not afraid to die anymore. I'm not afraid for that curtain to come. Because I've told myself, Kafira Murukuta, I'll die preaching. Those of you sometimes that visit me don't know I'm sick to the point of death, and I'm preaching the gospel to you. The day I'll die, I'll still be saying, I'm leaving you this one thing. Win one more soul. Live one more day victorious against sin. Live another hour victorious against sin. Live one more minute victorious against sin. That's my message to the world. Live victorious against that sin that easily besets you. That sin that causes you always to backslide. Is it alcohol? Is it pornography? Is it homosexuality? Is it careless talking? Careless jokes? I don't know what it is. I don't want to mention it. I want to exalt it on this altar. That ugly head of sin that easily beset you. The number one sin is prayerlessness. When you fail to pray, you are dead. When you fail to address your God, you are dead. When you fail to tell God your issues, you are dead. Your father is able to hear you. The quiet of your room is able to hear you in a hotel room. He's able to hear you no matter where you are. Just that one whisper. Say, God, I'm dying. I don't want to be a walking dead. There's a movie that I normally watch where I see the walking dead, and there are few that are living. The walking dead are consuming the living. This is what the world is coming to. It's full of the walking dead, and the walking dead are in the church. Rotten corpses, pretending to be children of the living God. God is not looking for children, He's looking for sons. Is your character that of the Son of God? Are you a mirror image of Jesus? Is your life the mirror image of Jesus? If it is not, it is time you begin to prepare. Because death will never knock. Death will never give you warning, I'm coming. Death will never tell you it is time. It comes like a thief in the night. You may say, Nikafru, kamene yako kanga kupai. Others just said, Nikamudu, there are no more. Others say, Iya ininjinga cha beani punga, there are no more. Others just say, Iya inika spider nkangono cha bekani ruma, there are no more. Who knows what can attack you today? And there are no more. Are you ready? Are you ready? Is your heart ready? Is your lifestyle ready? Do you live victorious? The church doesn't like this message anymore. They want to hear you are blessed. They want to hear you will prosper. They want to hear the kingdom of heaven is open over your head. But never repent. Never repent. I don't want to hear repent. Leave homosexuality. Leave that dirty life behind. We are like pigs. Ngumba olo isuke branch. Imafuna ya pwere ila pa matika yake. You know pig is white, eh? But when you walk into the pig's sty, the pig has covered itself in mud. The owner of the pig gets it, clean it. The pig will go back. Are you a pig? Ask yourself that. Niwe ngumba. Yamine mapwerera kumatika. Decide today when I'm clean, I'm made clean. I must die to whatever stops me from the resurrection power.